Hi all, today we can have a discussion on the poem. This is a photograph of May written by Margaret Atwood. This is a prescribed poem for the 6th semester UG students under the University of Calicut in the paper American and Postcolonial Literature. American and Postcolonial Literature has got two sessions, American Literature and Postcolonial Literature, and this particular poem, this is the photograph of me, comes under the Postcolonial Literature, and this is the first lesson in the Postcolonial session. So, let us come to the poem. This is the photograph of me, written by Margaret Atwood. Margaret Atwood is one of the most widely read authors of the contemporary world. She is a contemporary writer. She's a novelist, she's a short story writer, poet, critic, and she occupies a very prominent place in the modern literary scene. She was born in 1939 in Ottawa, Canada, and she published her first collection of poems entitled The Circle Game in 1966. She published her first collection of poetry in 1966 and it was entitled as The Circle Game, and it won the Governor General's Award. So, Margaret Atwood is a contemporary writer, she is a Canadian writer, and she is a poet, short story writer, and a novelist. Though she wrote many poems, short stories, etc., and it was successful, she is primarily known as a novelist. And her very controversial novel, The Edible Woman, was published in 1969. Her very controversial novel was The Edible Woman, which was published in 1969, and it deals with the issues faced by women. And other notable works of Margaret Atwood are The Survival, published in 1972, and The Handmaid's Tale in 1985, Cat's Eye in 1989, The Robber Bride in 1994, etc. Okay. The Blind Assassin, which was published in 2000, won the Man Booker Prize in 2000. So, she won the Man Booker Prize in 2000 for her work, The Blind Assassin. And her works are translated into more than 30 languages. And let us come to our particular poem. This is the photograph of me. And it was taken from the collection, The Circle Game, which is her first collection, which was published in 1966. So, it is from The Circle Game, the poem. This is the photograph of me. And the poem is a pageant depiction of how womanhood is misinterpreted and underrated by a male-oriented society. How womanhood is misinterpreted, how womanhood is marginalized, how womanhood is underrated, or how it is sidelined in a male-dominated society. We all know well that we are living in a male-dominated or patriarchal society where the rules and regulations of the society was primarily constructed by the male community. So, women will be always treated as secondary or marginalized in that particular community. And another point to be noted is that this comes under the section of post-colonial literature, that is literature from the colonized nations. So, a colonized nation is marginalized. As a woman living in a colonized nation, they are doubly marginalized in terms of culture and in terms of gender. So, that is a point to be noted, that if it is a woman's writing from a post-colonial nation or from a colonized country, we have to keep in mind that they are doubly marginalized. They are marginalized in terms of culture because they are coming from a post-colonial nation from a colonial nation, and they are marginalized in terms of a gender as they are women. So, I hope you will read this poem, and I have shared the poem here. So, please go through the poem and we can have an analysis of the poem. And she talks about the photograph, and there she discusses the problem of identity crisis for women. She is passive. The woman presented here is passive because the female was always passive in the construction of history, because it is the history constructed by the male community. The male are constructing the history, and female was always passive in that particular proportion. And she says that she was there when the photo was taken, but her photo was taken by others. her photo was taken by others. This is a point to be noted, because her photo was taken by others. That means her history was written by others. The history of the female, the history of women was written by others. So it is their perspective. ഒരാളുടെ ഹിസ്റ്ററി മറ്റൊരാൾ എഴുതുമ്പോൾ അത് അവരുടെ പേഴ്സ്പെക്റ്റീവിലാണ് നമുക്ക് കിട്ടുന്നത്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് നോട്ട് വാട്ട് വിമൻ ആക്ച്വലി ആർ, ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വാട്ട് മെൻ തിങ്ക്സ് അബൌട്ട് വിമൻ. വാട്ട് ഈസ് മെൻസ് പേഴ്സ്പെക്റ്റീവ് ഓൺ വിമൻ. ഫീമെയിലിനെ പറ്റിയിട്ട് മെയിലിൻ്റെ പേഴ്സ്പെക്റ്റീവാണ് നമുക്ക് കിട്ടുന്നത്, ബിക്കോസ് ദി ഹിസ്റ്ററി ഈസ് ഓൾവേസ് കൺസ്ട്രക്റ്റഡ് ബൈ ദി മെയിൽ കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റി. ആൻഡ് ദി മെയിൽ കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റി വാസ് ആക്റ്റീവ് ടു മേക്ക് ഹിസ്റ്ററി ഓഫ് ദി ഫീമെയിൽസ്. ആൻഡ് she was in the left hand corner. She was in the left hand corner. There are branches of the tree in the left hand corner of the photograph, and she was in the left hand corner. You can notice it in the poem. And there is a concept to depict female as the left hand and male as the right hand. It is a construction of the patriarchal society, because normally the right hand is considered as something superior, much more superior. Right hand is considered as something which has got strength, and the left hand is much more weaker compared to the right hand. So women is always considered as the left hand and men as the right hand. That's why she says that she was in the left hand corner. There is a frame house in the right hand side which stands for the male, and there are branches of the tree on the left hand side which stands for the female. So the left hand side there are branches which stands for the male, and in the left hand side there are branches which stands for the female, and right hand side stands for the male. In patriarchy, woman is treated as the left hand and man is treated as the right hand. നമുക്ക് മലയാളത്തിലും ഉണ്ട് ഇങ്ങനത്തെ കൺസെപ്റ്റ്. നമ്മൾ ഭാര്യനെ പറ്റി പറയുമ്പോൾ വാമഭാഗം എന്ന് പറയും. വാമഭാഗം ലെഫ്റ്റ് ഹാൻഡ് സൈഡ് ആണ്. സോ വിമൻ ആർ ഓൾവേസ് ഡിപിക്റ്റഡ് ആസ് ദി ലെഫ്റ്റ് ഹാൻഡ് സൈഡ് വിച്ച് ഈസ് മച്ച് മോർ വീക്കർ കമ്പയർ ടു ദി റൈറ്റ് ഹാൻഡ് സൈഡ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദി കൺസ്ട്രക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് ദി പാട്രിയാർക്കൽ സൊസൈറ്റി. ആൻഡ് in further analysis we can say that we can understand that the lake stands for the society in the photograph. The lake, I hope you all have read the poem, then only you could understand the analysis. Here in the poem the lake stands for the society in the poem. And the photograph was taken a day before the poet had drowned. This photograph was taken a day before the poet has drowned, and she was there. The poem ends with a very revolutionary line, because we can neglect the presence of female, we can marginalize her, we can sideline her, but we cannot deny that she was there. Her presence was there, she was there, and it is evident one day she will arise. And the passive voice of the title in the beginning of the poem and the first line suggests that in the creation of history, the narrator, here the narrator is a woman, she was passive. So the poem has got a passive title, "This is the photograph of me." And in the beginning line of the poem, it was taken some time ago. These both are written in the passive voice, and it depicts that at the time of history, at the time of creation of history, female was passive, and the male world is active. The male world is the active creator of the world's story and its rules. So men created all the rules and regulations here, and female was active, and she did not participated. She did not participate in that process of creation. And the photograph stands for the history seems to be a vague in the first glance. It was not clear in the first glance, but on a closer look one can recognize the hidden traces on it. So in the first glance it was vague, it was not clear, but in a closer look one can understand the hidden traces. The history written by man does not depict female in it. History doesn't tell the first hand information about female. Her image is distorted for the convenience of man. Her image is distorted. ആണുങ്ങളുടെ കൺവീനിയൻസിനനുസരിച്ചിട്ട്, പുരുഷന്മാരുടെ കൺവീനിയൻസിനനുസരിച്ചിട്ട് ഫീമെയിലിൻ്റെ ഹിസ്റ്ററി അവർ ഡിസ്ട്രോട്ട് ചെയ്യാണ്, വളച്ചൊടിക്കുകയാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. സോ ഷി വാസ് നോട്ട് ആൻ ആക്റ്റീവ് പാർട്ടിസിപ്പേറ്റർ ഇൻ ദാറ്റ്. ആൻഡ് ദി വുമൻ ഹാസ് ഡ്രൗൺഡ് ഇൻ ദി ലേക്ക്. That's another point to be noted. The woman has drowned in the lake. She is not visible in the photograph. But still she is present just below the surface. She was drowned in the lake. She is not that much visible in the photograph, but she was there. Her presence is there. And she was present just below the surface. However hard the world tries, the place of womanhood cannot be underwritten. However hard the society, the male-dominated patriarchal society, tries to underrate her, she is there. We cannot deny her presence. So this is all about, this is a very short analysis of the poem. This is the photograph of May, written by Margaret Atwood. I hope this is useful for you. Thank you all.